3, 2, 1.
Life has to be more than about solving problems. There have to be things that make you proud to be a member of humanity. The Apollo program is certainly an example of that. I don't think anyone would say that was a bad idea. Only a handful of people went to the moon. We need more of those things. At least we need some of those things. If someone's in a completely different industry and in a different, completely different walk of life, it's still something that's going to make you feel good about the world. That's another reason why I think we should try to do these great things.
The space race, once a competition between rival countries, has become a battle of the billionaires. The most prominent names are Elon Musk, who seeks to colonize Mars with his SpaceX venture, and Jeff Bezos, who envisions a future with his rocket manufacturer Blue Origin, where millions of humans are both living and working in space.
So the United States has been uncompetitive in the international launch market for a long time. Russia has actually been the leader in that regard, followed by Europe, and then to a lesser degree, India and China, although China is obviously growing rapidly. Except in the last few years where the United States has done the best, and that's due entirely to SpaceX.
Elon Musk is a man who needs no introduction. As the founder of SpaceX, he sold his former company PayPal in 2002 to make way for a visionary new company in the booming space industry. Since then, he has developed the Dragon spacecraft, which was the first private spacecraft to carry astronauts and dock at the International Space Station. On the other hand, Blue Origin has yet to launch a rocket into orbit, let alone with humans on board. Its rocket, called the New Glenn, is being prepared and the company is aiming to launch in 2021.
I have been interested in rockets, space travel, propulsion, since I was a five-year-old boy. And I have spent a tremendous amount of time thinking about it. So it's not like I really have a choice to follow this passion. It has captured me. I think it's very important that we go out into space as a civilization.
The ultimate goal for Elon Musk is to enable the colonization of Mars and become multiplanetary species, because he believes humans are at risk of becoming extinct in the hands of artificial intelligence or other potential planetary catastrophes.
If you look at things over a broad span of time, the things that are less important kind of fall away. And if you look at things from the broadest possible span of time as it relates to life itself, the evolution of life has been, primitive life, I think, started around 3.5 to 3.8 billion years ago. What are the important steps in the evolution of life? And obviously there was the advent of single-celled life, there was differentiation to plants and animals, there was mammals, consciousness, and I would argue also on that scale should fit life becoming multiplanetary. And in fact, I think consciousness, it's the next step, actually, because you really kind of need consciousness to design vehicles that can transport life over hundreds of millions of miles of irradiated space to an environment that they did not evolve to exist in.
Jeff Bezos, however, has slightly different motivations for going to space. The Amazon founder wants to create large flowing settlements in space, holding a million people or more that can support animals and plants, as well as creating gigantic parks for space tourism. He calls these settlements orbital habitats because they would have a bioreactor, atmosphere, utility, and supply modules, and it would enable an ecological system where animals can survive off of collected nutrients which can be mined from the cosmos. His orbital habitats can be boosted away with rockets that propels them into space-bound orbits, much like a satellite. Both companies are developing large reusable rockets capable of carrying people and satellites across space. They are competing to develop an all-important lunar lander for NASA's Artemis mission in 2024. In 2018, SpaceX sent an AI-based robot called Simon, short for Crew Interactive Mobile Companion, to the International Space Station. It was designed to help astronauts perform their work, such as specific experiments. It became the first AI technology to be launched to the space station. In September 2020, SpaceX announced the agreement with the United States Space Force to recover the first stage booster and, for the first time, on a national security space launch mission, launch previously flown boosters on future GPS missions. SpaceX was also recently selected by the Space Force to carry out critical national security space launch missions ordered over the next 5 years. The Blue Origin-led national team, comprising Blue Origin, Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper, is developing an integrated landing system for the NASA Artemis Human Landing System program, managed at NASA's Marshall Space Flight Center, to return Americans to the lunar surface. The Blue Origin-led team had an aggregate total of 62 design and construction standards spread across the three partners that comprise the integrated lander, aiding in the rapid progress expected by NASA's human landing system.
Your grandchildren's grandchildren will face this choice. Do you want to live in a world of stasis, or do you want to have a trillion humans living in the solar system? Once you go out into space, you have, for practical purposes, once again, unlimited resources. And the solar system can easily support a trillion humans. If you had a trillion humans, then you'd have 1,000 Mozarts and 1,000 Einsteins and so on and so on. That would be a dynamic, incredible civilization in which you would want your grandchildren's grandchildren to live in.
Elon Musk, with the creation of SpaceX's latest spacecraft, Starship, and the Super Heavy rockets, wants to revolutionize space travel. Once ready, it will be a fully reusable transportation system designed to carry both crew and cargo to Earth orbit, the Moon, Mars, and beyond. Starship, according to Elon, will be the world's most powerful launch vehicle ever developed, with the ability to carry in excess of 100 metric tons to Earth orbit. This will also have an impact in Earth transportation as well. Imagine a journey from London to New York taking less than 30 minutes. With Starship and Super Heavy, most international long-distance trips will be completed in 30 minutes or less.
The critical breakthrough that's needed for us to become a space-faring civilization is to make space travel like air travel. When you fly a plane, you fly that plane many times. I mean, at the risk of stating the obvious, really almost any mode of transport, whether it's a plane, a car, a horse, a bicycle, is reusable. You use that mode of transport many times. The critical breakthrough that's necessary is a rapidly reusable orbital rocket. This is basically the holy grail of space.
Meanwhile, Blue Origin is working on developing a rocket called New Glenn, which is being considered by the US Air Force to launch future national security satellites. New Shepard, a vertical takeoff and vertical landing rocket that Bezos wants to use for human space tourism, is designed to take astronauts and research payloads past the Karaman line, the internationally recognized boundary of space, and back during an 11-minute flight. SpaceX has been practicing propulsive landing with Falcon 9 for some time now. After all, in order to land on a place like the Moon, where there is no atmosphere, or Mars, where the atmosphere is too thin to land with wings, even if there were runways, you'd need to perfect the propulsive landing. The goal for Elon is to get the landing reliability that is on par with the safest commercial airliners. While SpaceX launch rate is very high by conventional standards, it is still very low in comparison to what will ultimately be needed. If you want to establish a self-sustaining base on the Moon or Mars, you need thousands of ships and thousands of refilling operations. This means you may need many launches per day. SpaceX boasts success in travel and the achievement of several groundbreaking milestones, whereas Blue Origin has only succeeded in landing rockets. This is not to say Blue Origin is not a legitimate rival in the race. It is important to know the difference between the two companies, their goals, and most of all, their reusable rocket technology. Bezos' space company is a serious force to be reckoned with in the space race, with a direct involvement in NASA's Artemis moon mission. NASA has yet to reach the moon again, and the Artemis mission is planned for 2024. Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin is ramping up to be extremely competitive in the upcoming era of reusable rockets, and Elon Musk has been doing the same. He also stated that reusability is absolutely fundamental. Both companies are paving the way towards a new era in space, and the next few years will be very exciting for the future of spaceflight, which is being built on the backbone of revolutionary 21st century reusable rockets. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.